What's up, everybody? It's Hey Ribbit! And we are diving back into Neverwinter. Where we last left off, we were on the Icespire. And apparently, I kind of meandered out of the camp. Sorry about that, we did not start off in the camp for some strange reason. Oh, that's right, we weren't in the camp, we were talking to this dude.
Watch your back. We're well behind enemy lines here.
Apologize if I don't talk too much today. Got a bit of a migraine going. Times with goblins. Shut. Let's see.
in, you guts!
Four guys. You'd have walked up the side of the mountain over here. Tropical goat. just joining us, we're still on the Icespire playing hockey with the goblins and shooting those little bowls. That is our youngest addition. He is extremely excited. He recently got back from getting, well, I call it being broken.
Thank you for the act of mercy, friend. The Ice Emerald Clan will not forget how many lives you saved today. Mr. Mine over there isn't just a mine. It used to be the Ice Emerald Clan's new stronghold on Icespire Peak. When the Giant's army overran us, we had to leave behind many of the treasures stored there, including the greatest clan treasure, the Ice Emerald. I've received orders from our leader, Foreign Icehammer, that the time has come to retrieve our clan's treasure. A frontal assault with our army will do no good, though. It has to be one person, or a small team, who can infiltrate behind enemy lines. Sounds like a perfect job for you. What do you say?
Because, you know, you're expendable. And you're not a dwarf. Thank you. that was a spider there for a second. That dust coming down, that is. They get a little stronger in the cave systems. Gotta love it. Nice little forge here. Or a barbecue pit, one of the two. growing some trees in the dark. Doesn't work like that, but hey. That's why this is fantasy. And yes, I know my team sucks. Top archer over here. Can't be doing that stuff to me, little goblin jerk. Say troll. as I thought it was going to be, but still a little on the interesting side there. Cost 1,000 years and many lives. A joke, of course. Mostly just lamenting how my controller is fallen prey to the let's hang a left syndrome. Seems to be very little I can do about it.
Their main army. That's why the Icehammer is so important. Our leader, Florin Icehammer, has brought a small band of elite warriors even farther up the mountain. Bring the Icehammer to him, and he'll explain further.
That's where we're going that way. storage of my stuff now. It's really nifty you got the really fast snail from the never-ending story, but, you know, poaching is not cool. First, I thought it was a spelljammer ship, but it looks like it's actually carved, so probably not a spelljammer. Probably used to be a monument that fell over. And real quick, if you don't know, spelljammer is another D&D property where basically you have ships that run on magic and you fly through space, and it's another way of visiting various worlds that you're not a part of. For instance, if you're here in Faerun and you decide you want to go over to Dragonlance's Kryn, and you don't have a portal or something, you could always hitch a ride on a spelljammer, assuming you can find one. They normally don't advertise, and it's also fairly hard because all the solar systems tend to be covered in a crystal sphere, and apertures only open occasionally, so...
As much as it grates on my pride to admit it, we can use all the help we can get. The ice hammer. With this, we can quiet the source of Rimner's power. To spread otherworldly coldness to all of Icespire Peak and beyond. Further up the mountain, you'll find icy spires coming up from the ground, freezing everything nearby. I want you to melt them. Here, take this orb. It's made by that traitorous wizard that conned us out of our gold. I told him to make it specifically to destroy the ice spires. It wasn't cheap, but it works in a simple way. With all the trouble you made for the giants down at Tarunda and the triage camp, Grimnir ordered 3 of his top lieutenants to personally come oversee things up here. They're fanatically devoted to Grimnir, and just as merciless and cruel. They call themselves Grimnir's Hands. They need to die. What do you say, adventurer? Feel like testing your mettle against some frost giants?
Wait, those big blue things were frost giants?
Grimnir and his tribe is...
I mean, no offense, it's just I've seen bigger frost giants.
Name's Orift. I'm in charge of our scouts and spies here in the White Cracks. Florin ordered me to bring her best scouts and spies with us here to this forward camp. Even now, they're watching the giants' every move from deep behind the enemy lines. The problem is getting that information back from them, so we can make decisions. Before I sent them out, I instructed them to leave messages carved into the stone of the mountain for us to find. And I'm expecting some of the reports back very soon. Trek a ways up the mountain and bring back the communications they've left for us.
Going back to what I was saying, if you had time and you could find them, spelljammer is one way. You could visit other worlds in D&D. of the other ways, of course, is, as I mentioned, Faerun, or Forgotten Realms, such as this, used to have portals from the old civilization that would have fit the bill. Of course, I'm not sure if those portals were a direct link or if they went to Sigil, also known as the City of Doors. That's a, another D&D property called, I remember correctly. Oh, I'm frozen. Planescape. It's stuff like Planescape and Spelljammer, unfortunately, that causes, Wizards of the Coast, among others, so much trouble reconciling the D&D cosmology, especially whenever they release a new edition, because there are so many different ideas floating around. And every time they come up with a new edition, they have to figure out, well, if we include this, how do we do it? A good example is one of my personal favorites is Ravenloft. As it used to be, that was its own demiplane of dread, as it was referred to. And it was basically a big roach motel. You get checked in, but you didn't check out. And over time, they changed that since the third edition. Now it's a, for a while there, it was part of the Raven Queen's area. Now that just sort of floats around in the negative energy plane. I mean, it's just, like I said, they have trouble reconciling certain things because different writers have different ideas. Sometimes it's easy. Sometimes it's an absolute headache. Check out some of the other properties, because D&D had a whole mess of them when they were TSR. And, I mean, to my knowledge, Wizards and Hasbro owned everything TSR had, well, most everything. To my knowledge, they don't have Conan's Barbarians trademark, and D&D did indeed, had that for a short time, but a lot of people have held that for a short time, to be fair. Reconciled that. killed the giant when I wasn't looking. Thank you. There we go.
You are beneath me.
Giant Ken. tells me where to go.
Messages from our scouts, eh? Good. Any commander worth his rank knows the value of good information. Good work destroying those spires. The more frozen wasteland those spires create, the more advantage the frost giants will have over us. There's some impressive work there. With the hands dead, their forces will be that much more in disarray, and that much less prepared for our next attack. By destroying those spires and slaying the hands, you've dealt the giants a mighty blow. We may have the opportunity now to deal even more damage, if the information you collected from our scouts is correct. Talk to Orif Mountwatch, my spymaster here. He will explain to you what it is that we would ask you to do.
Listen closely. Our two best agents, Aaron Rockstrider and Rurik Hillhill, are stationed at the very top of Icespire Peak. In their messages, they said that there was an opportunity for a small force to strike a blow against the Frost Giants. The message was too short for specifics, however. Florin and I agree that this opportunity cannot be passed over. We've just completed digging our secret tunnel to Jotunstead. Take the tunnel and climb to the top of the mountain. Make contact with the two scouts and see exactly what this opportunity is.
Well, I think this is a good place to stop for a moment. Looks like we will be going up the mountain in a bit. But I'd like to thank everybody who's watching, both present and future. If you like what I do, feel free to send me a link, a line, you know, DM me, like what I do, like, join my channel. Should you want to see some of my older videos, head over to YouTube. I'm at HeyRibbit21, and you can see me playing Neverwinter, you can see me beating up Skyrim with just my fists, and a couple other games here and there. But should you actually want to see me play a certain game, you know, like I said, drop me a line. I'll see what I can do about arranging it. And of course, liking and subscribing helps the channel grow, both here on Twitch and on YouTube, so please do try to subscribe. Other than that, thank you very much for watching, and I hope everybody has a great day.